Welcome to Avamar Fundamentals. This course covers an introduction to EMC Avamar. It includes an overview of Avamar terminology, features, and components, including Avamar backup and restore functions. The course reviews Avamar tools for monitoring and maintaining an Avamar system. This module focuses on introducing the Avamar solution, its key benefits, and use cases. EMC Avamar is a comprehensive client-server network backup and restore solution. With its unique global data deduplication technology, Avamar addresses the data protection challenges in today's IT environments. The ever-increasing amount of data to backup presents a challenge to organizations facing the demands of shorter backup windows, quicker restore responses, consistent backups of remote sites, and regulatory requirements, all with the need to accomplish this with fewer staff and tighter budgets. Avamar meets these challenges by redesigning backup and restore as a true disk-based process. Avamar's patented global deduplication technology reduces the amount of backup data in identifying unique data at the source. Avamar stores only one copy of this common data across the backup network. This results in a dramatic reduction in the amount of data that is moved across the network and stored in backup storage. The same data is backed up as in traditional backup systems, but consumes significantly less network and backup resources, as only unique data is stored. And by using standard IP network technologies, dedicated backup networks are not required. Avamar employs a scalable disk-based server architecture built of modules that provide balance of connectivity, security, processing, and disk storage resources. Scheduled backup and replication functionality enable efficient backup of remote sites and provide disaster recovery of primary backup sites. Avamar provides a user-friendly interface for central management of the entire backup system. A high percentage of data that is retained on backup media by most backup solutions is highly redundant. The typical backup process for most organizations consists of a series of daily incremental backups and weekly full backups. Daily backups are usually retained for a few weeks, and weekly full backups are retained for several months to several years. Because of this process, multiple copies of identical or slowly changing data are retained on backup media, leading to a high level of data redundancy. A large number of operating systems, application files, and data files are common across multiple systems in an enterprise. Identical files such as Word documents, PowerPoint presentations, and Excel spreadsheets are stored by many users across an environment. Backups of these systems will contain a large number of identical files. Additionally, many users keep multiple versions of files that they are currently working on. Many of these files differ only slightly from other versions, but are seen by backup applications as new data that must be protected. Backing up redundant data increases the amount of backup storage needed and can negatively impact network bandwidth. Organizations are running out of backup window time and facing difficulties meeting recovery objectives due to the need to manage backup versions and a myriad of backup tapes. Avamar differs from traditional backup and restore solutions by identifying and storing only unique subfile data objects. Redundant data is identified at the source, drastically reducing the amount of backup data that travels across the network to be stored and managed by the backup host. When storing data objects, Avamar takes maximum advantage of inherent hard disk characteristics. Avamar also creates and stores trees that link all data objects from a single backup. These trees are used to recreate files for restore. The Avamar solution includes the following key features. Global data deduplication ensures that data objects are only backed up once across the backup environment. Systematic fault tolerance using RAID, RAIN, checkpoints, and replication provide data integrity and disaster recovery protection. Highly reliable, inexpensive disk storage is used for primary backup storage. Since standard IP network technologies optimize the use of the network for backup, dedicated backup networks are not required. Daily full backups are possible using existing networks and infrastructure. Scalable server architecture provides security and expandability. Additional storage nodes can be added to an Avamar multi-node server to accommodate increased backup storage requirements. Flexible deployment options include Avamar Virtual Edition and Avamar Data Store. Avamar supports a wide variety of client operating systems and applications, including Windows, Linux, Unix, NDMP, Microsoft SQL, Microsoft Exchange, SharePoint, and Oracle. With its global deduplication technology, Avamar is an efficient backup choice for VMware and remote office backup environments. Centralized management is also provided. Backup and Recovery Manager and Avamar Administrator interfaces enable remote management and monitoring of Avamar servers from a centralized location via internet access. Avamar can also integrate with Data Protection Advisor for further monitoring capabilities. An Avamar backup is defined as a point-in-time copy of client data that can be restored as individual files, selected directories, or entire file systems. Initialization is the process of running a first backup from a client. This backup will usually take longer to complete because all of the backup data is new to the Avamar server. Thus, little to no deduplication can take place. A restore is an operation that retrieves one or more file systems, directories, or files from an existing backup and writes it to a designated location. Transmission encryption, or in-flight encryption, provides enhanced security during client-server data transfers and on the Avamar server. For Avamar client-server communication, Avamar supports two levels of encryption, medium and high. The administrator can also choose to turn off client-server encryption entirely. The exact method and bit strength used in a given circumstance depends on several factors, including client OS and Avamar servant client versions. Please refer to the Avamar product security manual for additional details. In addition to in-flight encryption, an Avamar server can be configured to encrypt all backup data on disk. Retention determines the length of time that a backup is available for restores. Avamar allows you to specify how long a backup is retained. Unused chunks from backups that have expired are deleted from the system. Replication is the process of storing a logical copy of Avamar server data on another Avamar server to support future disaster recovery of the source server. Deduplication is a key feature of the Avamar system. Deduplication ensures that each unique object is stored only once on the Avamar storage system. Redundant backup data is eliminated at the client, drastically reducing the amount of data that travels across the network to be stored and managed by the Avamar backup server. As long as a data object is stored on the server, it is never resent to the server. This dramatically reduces network traffic and enhances backup storage efficiency, guaranteeing the most effective deduplication of data. Typically, deduplication commonality yields the following results. The initial file system is approximately 65% redundant data. The initial database commonality is approximately 35%. Day-over-day file system backups have a commonality of approximately 99.7%, and subsequent database backups are approximately 97%. The slide depicts a high-level logical process and data flow of an Avamar backup. During a scheduled backup or restore, the Avamar server generates a work order. The server then either pages the client agent or the client agent checks in with the server to pick up the work order. On the client, the Avamar agent traverses each directory in the backup. For each file, the agent checks the local file cache to see if the file has been backed up before. If there is no match in the file cache, the file is divided into variable-sized data objects, or chunks. The chunks are compressed and hashed. The hashes are used to quickly determine if the chunks have previously been stored. The client compares each hash with the entries in the local hash cache to see if the chunk has been stored before. If there is no match in the local hash cache, the client asks the Avamar server if the hash is present on the server due to its corresponding chunk being stored previously by a different client. If there's no match on the Avamar server, the hash and the corresponding data are transferred to the Avamar server and stored. the client cache files are updated accordingly. This process is repeated for the rest of the files included in the backup. There are three levels of deduplication commonly used in the backup industry: file level, fixed block level, and variable block level. With file level deduplication, a file is backed up to the server as long as it has not changed. Any repeated backup of an unchanged file does not store any new data. However, if there is any change to the file, no matter how small, the entire file needs to be backed up and stored again. Unless the backup client contains mostly static files, this is not a particularly efficient level of deduplication. With fixed block level deduplication, each file is first broken into equal length blocks of data. These individual blocks of data are backed up and stored. The backup server keeps track of how to reassemble the file in the event that a restore is needed. With this level of deduplication, only changed blocks of data need to be stored. If there is a change in one bit of a large file, only the block containing that bit is stored on the backup server. There is no need to store the unchanged blocks. As a result, deduplication rates are much higher. However, fixed block level deduplication does have an inefficiency in the event that data is inserted into or deleted from a file. Inserting or deleting data causes a shift in all the data after the point of insertion or deletion. This causes all the blocks after that point to be different. The data is the same, but the blocks get cut at different points. So a small insertion of data near the beginning of a file can cause the entire file to be backed up and stored again. Variable block level deduplication solves this inefficiency. Instead of creating blocks of fixed length, the file is scanned and blocks are cut whenever the data matches a pattern. The pattern is determined by a mathematical algorithm that will consistently find the same boundary points within the data. In the example on the screen, a simplified algorithm is used. Blocks are divided after any vowel letter. This way, if data is changed, inserted, or deleted, the boundary points do not change. The algorithm will find the same boundary points. Only the block of data that has changed needs to be backed up and stored again. This level of deduplication is the most efficient and is the level that is used by Avamar. Hashes are used to store and find data objects. Three types of hashes are created during a backup: atomic, composite, and root. The hash created directly from a data chunk is referred to as an atomic hash. Atomic hashes are combined into composites and hashed to create composite hashes. All the composite hashes are combined and hashed once more to create a single root hash for the backup. When data is sent to the Avamar server during a backup, data object storage is used to manage the objects on the server. Both the chunk that has gone through the compression process and its corresponding hash are stored. Part of the number of the hash is used as an address to identify the location where the corresponding data chunk is stored on backup disk storage. Because each hash is a random and unique number, data is automatically evenly distributed across all available storage nodes and disks within an Avamar system. This type of address is called an object address. It eliminates the need for a separate file level catalog. Once an object has been stored, it cannot be deleted until the specified retention period has expired and it is not used by any current backup. Storing data on disk rather than on tape streamlines the process of searching for stored objects. Data is stored using a complex hierarchical hashing file system with an indexing structure consisting of the data elements grouped together by multiple levels of hashes, composites, and root hashes. The root hash of each backup links to the data objects and hashes comprising the backup at the point in time when the backup occurred. Data objects are stored on Avamar disk storage in special files called data stripes. Each data stripe is created with some pre-allocated space and is then filled with data. A single data stripe can hold approximately 30,000 objects. Composite hashes are stored in separate stripes. Root hashes, as well as information about the origin of the files, are stored in the accounts stripes. On a RAIN system, an additional stripe file contains RAIN parity data. This data is used to reconstruct data for a failed node. These additional Stripe files account for the RAIN overhead. For restore, Avamar presents a full backup as a single point in time. Each backup has its own root hash, linking to the data objects and hashes which comprise the specific backup at the point in time when the backup occurred. For a restore initiated by Avamar Administrator, MCS contacts AvAgent on the applicable client. AvAgent starts Avtar, and Avtar connects to a GSAN on the Avamar server. GSAN processing locates the chunks necessary to fulfill the restore request and sends the chunks to the Avtar process running on the clients. The chunks are collected in the client's memory, ordered, uncompressed, and then written to disk on the client. Avamar is ideally suited for protecting clients in virtual environments by reducing the amount of backup data within and across the virtual machines. Both VMware and Hyper-V are supported. Avamar provides a high level of integration with VMware for backing up virtual environments. Avamar provides the flexibility of implementing a virtual machine backup solution in two ways. Avamar agents can be installed in the virtual machines for guest level backups. Image level backups are also available to create a backup of the virtual disk files. VMware backups can be centrally configured, scheduled, and managed with Avamar Administrator. Avamar Administrator also has the ability to browse the virtual machines in the environment and display information for each machine as shown in the slide. Data domain systems can be used as storage for Avamar backup data. Backup data is sent directly from the client to the data domain system using ddBoost technology. Backup metadata used to identify files and backup is stored on the Avamar. Backups can then be managed through the Avamar system. This can provide faster backup and recovery, especially for large active databases. Data domain integration is supported for file system data, NDMP data, Lotus Domino, DB2, Microsoft Exchange VSS, Hyper-V VSS, Microsoft SQL Server, Microsoft SharePoint VSS, Oracle, SAP with Oracle, Sybase, and VMware Image Backup and Restore. Maintenance activities that are performed on the Avamar server are also performed on any data stored on the data domain. This means that a backup that has expired or been deleted on the Avamar server will be deleted from the data domain. Avamar garbage collection, checkpoints, rollbacks, and HFS checks, and replication trigger similar processes on the data domain system. More information on these maintenance activities are discussed later in this course. Backing up NAS data can be a challenge. NAS devices typically store large amounts of files. They also have native operating systems that do not always allow backup software to be installed. Network Data Management Protocol, or NDMP, was developed to address these concerns. The Avamar NDMP Accelerator provides support for NAS appliances by interfacing between the appliance and the Avamar server. The NDMP Accelerator is used to back up and restore EMC Isilon and VNX IP storage systems and network appliance filers. The NDMP Accelerator is a dedicated single-node Avamar client that, when used as part of an Avamar system, provides a complete backup and recovery solution for supported NAS systems. The NDMP Accelerator hosts a special version of the Avamar client and acts as a pass-through conduit from the NAS device to the Avamar server. Data streams through the NDMP Accelerator. No user data is stored on the NDMP Accelerator. The accelerator accepts NDMP data from the NAS appliance, performs data deduplication, then forwards the data to the Avamar server. When performing backups of remote sites to a primary data center, the recommended backup solution is to place an NDMP accelerator at each remote site. Because Avamar architecture is extremely flexible and scalable, Avamar is an ideal solution for distributed enterprises. Corporate backup policies can be implemented, enforced, and managed throughout the organization from a central location. Avamar supports both local area network and wide area network connections. There is minimal impact to network traffic and performance as, after initialization, only changes travel over the network. Unless recovery time objectives cannot be met, an operational best practice is to back up clients to a large, active, centralized Avamar server and then replicate data to another large passive centralized Avamar server. As a centralized backup system, Avamar protects critical branch data without the addition of hardware or specially trained personnel at branch office sites. For sites where recovery time objective requirements must be satisfied, a local Avamar system may be employed to back up local data at the site, then automatically replicate the data to a large centralized Avamar server. The primary advantage of backing up to a local Avamar backup server is that restores can be done directly from that server across the local area network to the client. All backup and replication activity is managed from the central data center using the Backup Recovery Manager and Administrator interfaces. Employing Avamar disk-based backup eliminates the need to manage complex tape systems for backups, restores, and offsite security. For more information about backing up clients in remote offices, please see the EMC Avamar Operational Best Practices document. This module covers the Avamar solution, its key benefits, and use cases. This module focuses on Avamar architecture, terms, and system components. The three major components of an Avamar system are the Avamar server, Avamar backup clients, and the Avamar administrator. The Avamar server stores client backups and provides essential processes and services required for client access and remote system administration. Avamar Administrator Server and the Avamar Data Server run on the Avamar server. Avamar Client Software runs on each computer or network server that is being backed up. Avamar provides client software for various computing platforms. Each client consists of a client agent and one or more plugins. Avamar Administrator is a user management console software application that is used to remotely administer an Avamar system from a supported Windows or Linux computer. There are several terms used when discussing Avamar. When data is stored on an Avamar, it is first broken up into pieces called objects or chunks. These chunks are variable-sized units of deduplicated data, meaning that identical chunks will never be stored twice on the Avamar server. When chunks of data are stored on an Avamar, they are placed onto disk in stripes. Stripes are units of disk space that store data chunks and are managed by an Avamar. An Avamar server will have many stripes containing all the data that is backed up to it. These stripes are stored on disk on an Avamar node. A node is a self-contained, rack-mountable, network-addressable computer consisting of both processing power and hard drive storage. Nodes run Avamar server software on the Linux operating system. Usually, multiple nodes will work together as one server, although a server can consist of a single node as well. A server functions as a single managed unit that stores and manages all backup data across its nodes. A server is also sometimes called an Avamar grid. An Avamar system is one or more servers that interact with one another and the clients that back up the data to them. Systems can be geographically dispersed due to Avamar's IP network architecture. If we take a look inside an Avamar server, we see that it contains multiple nodes and switches. All these components operate together as one server. For this reason, it is called a multi-node server. There are two main types of nodes, utility and storage. At the bottom of the rack is one utility node. This node is dedicated to providing internal Avamar server processes and services, such as the scheduling and management of backups, external authentication, and web access. The hostname and IP address of the utility node is the identity of the Avamar server for access and client-server communication. Above the utility node are multiple storage nodes. Notice that they are larger and have more disks than the utility node. This is because these nodes are dedicated to providing backup storage and keeping all the chunks of data organized. When backup data is sent to an Avamar server, it is distributed across the storage nodes and protected by parity data. Storage nodes can be added to a server to increase its capacity. An Avamar server can have anywhere between 3 and 16 active storage nodes. A spare storage node is also often included in a configuration and can be enabled in the event of a node failure. An Avamar server is often referred to according to the number of active storage nodes. For example, this is a DS12, meaning it has 12 active storage nodes. If two more storage nodes are added, it would become a DS14. At the top of the rack, there are two internal switches. These switches provide communication between all of the nodes in the Avamar server. Each node is connected to both switches so that a switch failure does not result in a loss of communication. Another type of Avamar server is the single-node server. In this configuration, one node performs the roles of both the utility and the storage nodes. Because data is not distributed across multiple nodes, as it was in the multi-node server, the failure of a single-node server will result in the unavailability or even loss of data. For this reason, a single-node server must provide some other means of data protection. It must either have its data replicated to another Avamar server, back up its checkpoint data to an integrated data domain, or use RAID 6 protection, as in the Avamar Business Edition single-node server. The NDMP accelerator is an optional specialized node that, when used as part of an Avamar system, provides a complete backup and recovery solution for NAS devices via the Network Data Management Protocol, or NDMP. Avamar supports EMC Isilon, VNX, and Celera, and NetApp filers with the NDMP accelerator. The Media Access node is an optional node that can be used as a pass-through device for sending Avamar backup data to tape for long-term storage. The two Avamar server editions provide the flexibility to meet different customer requirements. Avamar can be deployed either as physical hardware or as a virtual machine. The Avamar server runs on SUSE Linux Enterprise Server, or SLES. The Avamar server is capable of operating on server hardware with multiple processors. Beginning with Avamar Generation 4S hardware, three sizes of storage nodes are supported: 2 terabytes, 3.9 terabytes, and 7.8 terabytes of licensable capacity. Licensable capacity includes deduplicated data plus RAIN parity protection. All storage nodes within an Avamar server must be of the same size. Avamar Data Store simplifies the purchase and deployment of Avamar by delivering a prepackaged solution consisting of Avamar server software installed on-site on pre-configured and pre-tested Avamar-certified hardware. Deployment time at customer sites is reduced since hardware stress tests and initial benchmark tests are performed before the hardware is shipped. Avamar Data Store is available in several configurations as listed on the slide, including multi-node and single-node servers. Multi-node servers can be expanded by adding new nodes. Avamar Data Store is deployed by EMC-trained personnel. EMC Avamar Virtual Edition, or AVE, allows the Avamar solution to be standardized on virtual infrastructure. AVE is supported on VMware, Hyper-V, and Azure environments. It is ideal for small remote offices or small data centers by lowering the total cost of ownership through sharing the server and storage infrastructure and reducing the cost of hardware support and maintenance. AVE is a single-node, non-RAIN Avamar server running as a virtual machine on a virtualization host server. The license capacity sizes include 0.5 terabytes, 1 terabyte, 2 terabyte, and 4 terabytes. Each of these capacity versions has a set of minimum requirements for memory, disk I/O, and storage. The choice of AVE version to be deployed depends on the type of data in the environment to be backed up and the expected daily change rate. The host server is supplied by the customer. Installation of AVE on a virtual machine is performed by EMC-trained personnel. The AVE benchmark test must be run to ensure that the server hardware and the virtual environment meet the expected I/O performance benchmarks. Also, the benchmark tests help determine the impact of AVE on other virtual machines running on the same physical server. This module covered Avamar architecture, terms, and system components. This module focuses on introducing the features and capabilities of Avamar, including backup and restore, desktop laptop, and system integrity. Avamar backup clients are the machines that contain the data to be backed up to the Avamar server. They are networked computers or workstation accessing the Avamar server via a network connection. Avamar clients are usually the file servers and database servers in an IT environment or employee computers. Avamar client software is installed and running on each client. Avamar provides client software for various computing platforms. For backing up databases, the Avamar client and a specialized database plugin are installed and run on the same machine. Databases supported by Avamar client software include Microsoft Exchange, Lotus Domino, Microsoft SQL, SharePoint, DB2, and Oracle. System state can also be backed up with Avamar using a specialized module that is utilized by the backup client. This captures system settings, software installations, registry, networking information, and shares, and more. The backup of the system state can save time if a bare metal recovery needs to be performed. Avamar provides two backup types, scheduled and on-demand. Scheduled backups are run automatically according to specifications that can be customized by the administrator using the Avamar Administrator interface. On-demand backups can be initiated from the Avamar Administrator interface and the Management Console Command Line interface, or MCCLI. On-demand backups can also be run from a client machine using the Avamar Desktop Laptop interface and with the avtar command from the command line. Avamar uses groups to implement various policies for automating backups and enforcing consistent rules across a collection of clients. Backups are scheduled to run automatically by configuring and enabling groups. A group consists of one or more clients that will be backed up, and a group policy that is used to configure the settings for the backup. The group policy specifies a data set, schedule, and retention for that group. Once a group is configured, the Avamar server will automatically perform backups of the clients within the group according to the schedule that was set up for the group. The dataset settings for the group determine the data from each client that's backed up, and the retention settings determine how long each backup from the group is retained. Avamar groups should not be confused with Avamar domains. Groups are used to create automated backups for a set of clients, while domains are used to grant Avamar administration rights to a set of clients and to organize and manage sets of clients. Clients inherit the group policy settings by means of their membership in a specific group. An Avamar user with administrator privileges can configure persistent backup selections by creating, modifying, and deleting datasets, schedules, and retention policies, assigning them to a new or existing group, and then assigning clients to the group. Datasets define the persistent backup selections for the file systems, directories, or files to be included in a backup. You can also narrow the scope by specifying certain content, such as file types, to exclude or include. Datasets can be created at any domain level and can be assigned to one or more groups and clients within the assigned domain. The schedule for a group determines when and how often a backup will automatically be run. Schedules can be created at any domain level and can be assigned to one or more groups within the assigned domain. Retention policies specify how long each backup from the group will be kept. Any backups older than the specified retention are automatically dropped from the system. Retention policies can be created at any domain level and can be assigned to one or more groups and clients within the assigned domain. On-demand backups, by definition, are run manually at the time that the backup request is initiated. Avamar provides multiple ways for running on-demand backups from either the client or server side. An administrator can run an on-demand backup using the MCCLI command line, run a group backup from Avamar Administrator's policy view, or select items to backup from Avamar Administrator's backup, restore, and manage view, as shown on the slide. An on-demand backup can also be initiated from the client side using the avtar CLI command or using the desktop laptop interface. Desktop laptop provides an easy-to-use graphical user interface to be installed on a desktop or laptop and used by an end user. This allows the end user to perform on-demand backups and restores without help desk intervention. Desktop Laptop is included as an option in the Avamar Client Installer. It is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. End users can initiate an on-demand backup through the Desktop Laptop interface. This backs up data using the dataset and retention policies set by the Avamar administrator for the client. The end user must ensure that the data to be protected resides within a directory within the backup dataset. Desktop Laptop can optionally be configured to allow the end user to create their own dataset and apply their own schedule. Backups and restores over VPN are also supported. Avamar supports restoring one or more individual files, directories, or file systems from backups stored on the Avamar server. There are two methods of initiating restores of client data, from the Avamar server or from the client. Restores can be initiated from the Avamar server using Avamar Administrator Backup and Restore, or the MCCLI interface. Initiating the restore from the Avamar client is accomplished by the Desktop Laptop interface, or AVTAR command. Using the Avamar Administrator Backup and Restore view, the items to restore for a specific client can be selected either from a list of all backups for a particular date or of all backups containing a particular path. Restores can be performed using the Avamar Administrator by a user with administrator privileges. Restores can be directed to the original client or redirected to a different client. If Desktop Laptop is installed on the client machine, end users can restore their own data. Using the Desktop Laptop GUI, users can search or browse for the desired files and initiate a restore. Restores can only be performed to the client where the data originated. Redirected restores are not supported with Desktop Laptop. This user-initiated restore is quicker and easier because no calls to IT need to be made. Also, no additional passwords are needed. Desktop Laptop uses LDAP, or Active Directory Authentication, to ensure that the user is authorized to access their data. To ensure system integrity, Avamar provides systematic fault tolerance at the following levels. RAID is a method of protection for disk data corruption or failure. Avamar servers are protected by either RAID 1 or RAID 6, depending on the configuration. Avamar also has hot swap capability with minimum system impact for highest failure rate components. RAIN provides failover and fault tolerance across nodes. Data is distributed across each node, and parity data is used to provide protection. RAIN provides uninterrupted functionality during node failure, replacement, and reconstruction. In the unlikely event of a node failure, new backup data will be written onto the remaining nodes. Data for recoveries is reconstructed using parity. RAIN is used to replace the fail node, reconstruct the data on the replacement node, and, when expanding an Avamar server, rebalance the capacity across all nodes. High availability uplink and dual switches provide high availability in the event of hardware failure. Each node has the ability to have dual connections to the customer's switch. An Avamar server also has two internal switches in order to provide hardware redundancy. Checkpoints protect the server in the event of operational failures. They provide redundancy across time. Checkpoints are a read-only snapshot of the Avamar server taken to facilitate server rollbacks. They are created using hard links to all the stripes. Regular checkpoint validation, including auto repair capability, is used to ensure data integrity. Replication protects against data loss in the event of a server loss. Efficient scheduled replication, either local or remote, ensures availability and redundancy of data if the primary server is lost. Avamar replication is the process of logically copying backup data from one or more source Avamar servers to a destination or target Avamar server. As with the backup process, Avamar employs deduplication methodology at the source Avamar server, transferring only unique data to the target server and encrypting the data during transmission. Replication can be configured and run using the Avamar Administrator interface. Replication is most often run on a scheduled basis, but can also be run on demand. Replication can be configured in multiple ways to meet an enterprise's unique requirements. For example, replication can be used to provide disaster recovery protection of data from multiple single-node servers to a central multi-node server in a remote branch office to home office scenario. It can also provide peer-to-peer disaster recovery protection from a single-node to single-node server and multi-node to multi-node servers. The two basic kinds of Avamar replication are standard, also referred to as normal, and full copy, also known as root-to-root replication. Standard replication copies backup data from one or more source Avamar servers to a target Avamar server. Replicated data is stored within a special replicate domain on the target Avamar. With standard replication, an Avamar server can be both a replication source and target for replication. Data can be restored from replicated backups directly from the replication target Avamar server to a client activated on that server. Full copy, or root-to-root replication, creates a complete logical copy of an entire source server on the destination Avamar server. Only a one-to-one configuration is supported with full copy replication. Full copy replication is best suited for server migrations and high availability environments. Avamar uses two operational windows to perform various system activities. These windows can be customized to start and end at times to meet your site requirements. The backup window is when the majority of backups are performed. Backups should be scheduled to run during this time. No maintenance activities, such as garbage collection or HFS checks, are performed by the Avamar server during the backup window. The maintenance window is reserved for maintenance activities, primarily garbage collection, checkpoint creation, and HFS check. A limited number of backups may be initiated, but both backup time and maintenance activities will be impacted. By default, the maintenance window runs during the day from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Restores can be performed during any of these windows. Daily Avamar server maintenance activities include checkpoints, checkpoint validation, and garbage collection. These server maintenance activities are run automatically. A checkpoint is a read-only snapshot of the Avamar server taken to enable server rollbacks. Checkpoints are created using hard links to all the stripes. A hash file system, or HFS check, is an operation that validates the integrity of a checkpoint. It is also called a checkpoint validation. Once a checkpoint has passed an HFS check, it can be considered reliable enough to be used for a system rollback. Checkpoints are taken twice daily and validated once daily during the maintenance window. Avamar administrators can also create and validate checkpoints at any time, as well as delete checkpoints that are not needed in order to reclaim additional storage capacity. Garbage collection is the process of deleting unused chunks from backups that have expired. This frees up capacity on the Avamar server. Garbage collection runs once daily, starting at the beginning of the maintenance window. Beginning with Avamar 7.0, backups can be run during garbage collection. However, doing so should be avoided since it will negatively impact the performance of both the garbage collection and backup processes. For added data security, Avamar provides data encryption both in flight and at rest. In-flight encryption occurs during a backup or restore. During backup, data is encrypted by the client before it is sent over the network. This protects any data from being compromised as it is sent over a network. Encryption strength can be set to medium or high or disabled altogether. It is always recommended to use encryption, especially if performing a backup over a wide area network. Encryption at rest occurs when data is written to the Avamar disk. If encryption at rest is enabled, all data is stored in an encrypted format, so that even if data on disk was compromised, it would still be unreadable. Encryption at rest provides a high level of security for backed up data. This module covered Avamar Backup and Restore, Desktop Laptop, and System Integrity. This module focuses on various Avamar management and monitoring tools, including Avamar Administrator, Backup and Recovery Manager, and Data Protection Advisor. Avamar administration tools provide central administrative access to the Avamar system. The Avamar Administrator is a graphical user interface used to configure, monitor, and manage an Avamar system from one or more Windows or Linux clients. The Management Console Command Line Interface, or MCCLI, is a Java application providing command line access to the features and functions that are available via the GUI. REST API provides a way to develop applications and tools that interact with Avamar systems. For example, a developer may create a web interface to allow end users to initiate backups. Backup and Recovery Manager is a separate tool that can be used to monitor Avamar, Networker, and Data Domain systems. It allows backup administrators to monitor and manage all Avamar servers in a distributed environment. Client Manager is a tool within Backup Recovery Manager used to add and update backup clients to the Avamar system. When managing an Avamar, administrators log in under an Avamar domain. Domains are distinct zones within Avamar that are used to organize and manage backup clients. They are used to manage administration access to groups of clients. By nesting domains within domains to create a tree structure, you can create a hierarchy for managing organizations and the clients in those organizations. The highest level domain is the root domain, represented by the Avamar server in the hierarchy. When an Avamar client is added to an Avamar server, it is assigned to a specific domain within the domain hierarchy. The real power of domains is that they provide the ability to add specific login users to specific levels on the client tree. Security within the Avamar system is implemented through the use of user accounts. Users can be created at the root, domain, and client levels in the domain hierarchy. The level at which a user account is added to the Avamar system and the role assigned to the user determine the access and privileges accorded to that user. Actions performed by users are tracked and maintained in an audit log. The slide lists the roles that can be assigned to users at the following levels in the domain hierarchy. Root users are created at the root domain. Root users can perform tasks for all domains in the hierarchy and the clients within the domains. Domain users are created at the Avamar domain level. Users at the domain level can perform tasks for that domain, clients assigned to that domain, and any domain client beneath the domain in the domain hierarchy. Client users are created for an individual Avamar client. The tasks that a client user can perform are limited to that specific client. You can manage backups from the Avamar Administrator Backup Restore and Manage view. You can list the backups run for a particular client by first selecting the client in the tree and then choosing to list by date, date range, or retention type. Options available from the Actions menu include changing the backup expiration date, changing the retention tag, deleting a backup, viewing the completed backup statistics, and validating a backup. Validating a backup initiates a virtual restore of all files in the backup, but does not actually restore any files to the client file system. Deleting a backup permanently deletes the backup from the system. Note that data referred to by other backups will not be candidates for deletion. Avamar provides several ways to monitor backup activity while backups are in progress, and to report on backup status. The Avamar Administrator Activity View provides a central facility to monitor backup and restore progress and status. With the Activity Monitor, you can see a listing of all activity for the last 72 hours up to a maximum of 5,000 rows. You can also bring up activity logs and cancel an activity in progress. Options from the Action menu include filtering the activity results display and viewing statistics for a selected activity. Status information is also available on a Windows client with the Avamar progress bar and work order status. Client Manager is a graphical user interface accessible from within Backup and Recovery Manager, which provides many functions for managing large amounts of clients. It provides the ability to move multiple clients between domains or servers, and to retire or delete multiple clients, and to change backup groups of clients. It is especially useful in large environments, as clients can be found easily through the use of search filters. Client Manager can also be used to update client software and analyze backup statistics. Activation of multiple clients can be achieved through this interface. Clients can be discovered through the use of a directory service such as Active Directory, and then activated. Avamar activities and operational status are reported as events to the administrator server. Examples of events include client registration and activation, and backup completion and restore activity. The Avamar Administrator Event Monitor displays the most recent 5,000 system events during the past 24 hours. The listing can be filtered by event code, category, type, severity, and domain. The report can be exported to a CSV file. The Avamar Administrator Server View is a primary system status monitoring tool. With the functions within the server view, you can suspend or resume server activity, check server capacity, review the health of nodes and disks, and manage checkpoints and hash file system checks. The server monitor presents a summarized view of CPU, network, and hard drive performance statistics for each node. New bytes are added to the Avamar server through the backup process. Old bytes are removed from the server through the garbage collection of unused chunks from expired or deleted backups. The goal of managing the capacity of the Avamar server is to achieve a steady-state server capacity utilization, where the rate that new data chunks are added to the server is equal to or less than the rate that expired data chunks are removed from the server. Factors affecting capacity utilization include the amount of primary storage being protected, the initial day-over-day backup commonality, and the length of time backups are retained. Capacity management is an important task for the Avamar administrator to ensure that the Avamar system continues to have the capacity to store the required backup information. Avamar provides many tools and reports to assist the administrator with this task. For daily monitoring, the Avamar administrator dashboard, shown in the slide, provides capacity management information, including server capacity, forecasts, and warnings. Avamar automatically issues warnings when the server utilization exceeds 80% of user capacity and, at 100%, will go into read-only mode. EMC technical support is available to work with the administrator on all capacity management issues. If more capacity is needed, multi-node Avamar servers can be expanded with the addition of new nodes. Avamar maintains logs of client and server activities. Logs are especially useful for investigating issues and troubleshooting error conditions. The slide shows an excerpt from a client log detailing an on-demand backup operation. Many standard reports are available with the Avamar Administrator Activity Report and Manage All Reports features. Shown here is an example of one of the activity reports. You can also create reports using the read-only views of the Avamar Administrator Server database. Backend capacity reports can be generated to show how much capacity is used by a client or a group of clients after deduplication. Avamar provides a plugin for the VMware vSphere web client. This plugin adds a very basic Avamar interface into the existing vSphere web interface. With this interface, vSphere users can initiate image backups and restores of virtual machines in their environment. Limited monitoring of backup activity is also available. The purpose for the Avamar plugin for vSphere is to give VMware vSphere administrators the ability to perform basic backup and recovery tasks without requiring extensive Avamar knowledge. For this reason, many configuration tasks cannot be performed through this interface and must be performed through Avamar Administrator instead. The vSphere interface is primarily for monitoring scheduled backups, initiating on-demand backups, and performing restores. In addition to the vSphere interface, the plugin also enables end users to perform file-level restores from image-level backups. Users who are logged into a virtual machine can use a web interface to select individual files from a previous backup. VMware vCloud environments consist of very large numbers of vApps, each consisting of multiple virtual machines. vApps and VMs are constantly being created and deleted in a typical vCloud environment. Additionally, vClouds can be extremely large, many times with hundreds of thousands of virtual machines. If a large vCloud is going to be backed up by Avamar, multiple servers are required. However, managing multiple Avamar servers is difficult. Administrators have to track which portions of the vCloud are backing up to which Avamar servers. Avamar servers cannot share policy definitions, so many times policies would have to be created and managed multiple times on each Avamar. The Avamar plugin for vCloud moves Avamar Management to the vCloud Director interface. Instead of managing individual Avamar servers, an administrator views the cloud resources, such as vApps and organizations, and directs them to use backup resources. Backup policies can be configured and shared across the entire cloud, even if multiple Avamar servers are used. As a result, managing a large vCloud is much easier. Data Protection Advisor is a customizable backup reporting, alerting, monitoring, and correlation analysis software tool for EMC and third-party backup software products. Without Data Protection Advisor, administrators must rely on a mix of reporting and analysis tools to manage their backup environment and provide a complete picture of the infrastructure. Reports with Data Protection Advisor can be customized extensively to suit the demands of any business. DPA can be used in Avamar environments to provide increased monitoring abilities. DPA provides the ability to monitor the entire backup environment in addition to Avamar servers. It is able to predict future trends in order to prevent problems before they occur. DPA provides a single view of the entire infrastructure through data discovery, analysis, and reporting that leverages this data for key backup management functions. DPA incorporates backup solutions, replication technologies, virtual environments, tape, VTL storage, SAN, and NAS systems, and the business applications protected by the infrastructure. This module covered various Avamar management and monitoring tools, including Avamar Administrator, Backup and Recovery Manager, and Data Protection Advisor. This course covered an introduction to EMC Avamar. It included an overview of Avamar terminology, features, and components, including Avamar backup and restore functions. The course reviewed Avamar tools for monitoring and maintaining an Avamar system. This concludes the training.